Hello friends, this video on perimeter and area part 2 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam.
Let's start with a square. So square being one of the simplest polygons, let us see how do we find the perimeter and area of a square. So we start with perimeter. Now as I have said, what is perimeter? It is nothing but the total length of the boundary. So when you look at the square, which is the boundary? Obviously, this, the lines marked by in black. So these lines represent the boundary of the square. Now let us say that the length of each side is L, because in a square we know that the length of all the sides are equal. So if one side is L, all the other sides would also be L. So as per what we had discussed, perimeter is, what is perimeter? So perimeter for any geometrical shape is the total length of boundary. So what forms the boundary in a square? The four sides, right? So that means the sum of the length of the four sides. So L plus L plus L plus L. This would give you the total perimeter of the square. Now L added four times. What does that mean? So if you add the same number, multiple number of times, you can write it as 4 multiplied by L, or you can say that perimeter of a square is 4L, where L is the length of the side. So we conclude perimeter of a square is equal to 4 into side. What about area of a square? Now, instead of finding out the boundary, if we want to find out the region enclosed by the square. So area of a square is given by side multiplied by side. That is length of one side multiplied by length of one more side. So that's interesting. Now you might ask that how do we get that? So let us say the square that is given to us, the length of each side of the square is 10 centimeters. Okay, so if one side is 10, that means all the sides would be 10 centimeters in length. So this is the given square. Now if I have to find the area, so I actually need to find out the entire region, that is this entire yellow region which is enclosed within the square. So let us try to understand the concept like this. So let's say that this square is actually made up of many such lines, like the length of each of this line is 10 centimeters, right? So let us assume that this is a line of length 10 centimeters. Now when many such lines are stacked over each other, how many such lines? Now you see, we are just adding one line of 10 centimeter length. So what is happening? Gradually, we are getting a rectangle. Now if we keep adding more such lines of length 10 centimeter, what do we get? We finally get a square. But when do we get a square? We get a square when the length of this is also the length of the height, or the height is also 10 centimeter. So that means what we are actually doing is we are kind of multiplying this length, which is of 10 centimeter. How many times? We are multiplying it 10 times, because we want this also to be 10 centimeter. Please understand this. What we actually did was we started with one line of length 10 centimeter, so that is the length of this line, and now what we do, we keep adding more such lines. And till when do we add this? So we keep adding more and more lines until the height, or until the breadth, is also equal to 10 centimeter. That is until this length is also equal to 10 centimeter. So what are we actually doing? We are continuing to add one more line. So when we first added the first line, so let us understand it like this. So when we added the first line, if I ask you to find out the area of this line, so in this case, this is just one line, right? So you have just multiplied 10 into 1, because you just have one line of length 10 centimeter. Now the moment we added two lines, so what happened to the area? It is like 10 multiplied by 2, because now you have two lines. Now, in a similar way, if you keep adding one more line, it becomes 10 into 3, then 10 into 4, 10 into 5, 10 into 6, 10 into 7, and so on. And gradually, by the time you actually reach here, what happens? It is actually 10 into 10. So that is, you have actually multiplied one 10 centimeter line how many times? 10 times. And when you have placed that one 10 centimeter line 10 times, what happened? The entire area that is covered by these two lines together becomes 10 into 10. That is the area of the square. So please understand this. So this is how we get this concept, or this is how we actually derive the formula for area of a square. So I hope the perimeter part was clear, because there we were only concerned about the boundary. But in this case, we are concerned about the total area that is enclosed inside the square. So you have to assume that the square is actually made up of many lines. Each line's length is 10 centimeters. So therefore, we are basically multiplying that one line to get a square. So in that way, what would be the area of the square? The area of the square would be 10 into 10, that is 100 centimeter square. So this would be the area of this square. So what is the unit for area? Because in case of area, let's say it is, the length is 10 centimeter. So we are multiplying 10 centimeter with 10 centimeter. So centimeter multiplied by centimeter gives it centimeter square. Similarly, instead of centimeter, if the lengths are in meters, then the area would be in meter square. So meter square or centimeter square is the unit for area.
Thank you. Please visit examfear.com for free quality education. You can learn with a simple 4-step learning process wherein you can watch video lessons, you can ask your questions, you can refer notes, and you can take a free online test. We have content for class 6 to 12 on physics, chemistry, mathematics, and biology, along with practical videos. So please subscribe to our channel for daily updates. Thank you.